Two teens are dead, and now the Taos County Sheriff's Department says it knows who pulled the trigger.
The Sheriff's Department says they are looking for 18-year-old Jose Rivera. We are told an off-duty deputy drove by a car near mile marker 66 off Highway 518 and saw the car's headlights were still on. He went to see what was going on and found the 17 and 19-year-old victims dead inside. Friends of the victims say Taos has gone from a vacation town to a dangerous place to live.
Nowadays, I say Taos is it's getting a lot worse. It went from a retirement town to kind of like a little bit of a war zone type thing. And I think it's just going to get worse until there's no one left to do anything with it.
The Sheriff's Department believes Rivera is still in the Taos area. If you see him, call 911. Many people in the Taos area are on edge after the murders. They say violent crime is spreading. Action 7 News reporter Joe Griffin is in Taos with the latest on what law enforcement is doing about gang violence.
Doug and Shelley, the two victims as well as the alleged shooter, are all part of the same gang. Now, while this may not be gang-on-gang violence, people here in Taos County say they are afraid of an escalating gang problem, and law enforcement says they have the right to be scared. Gang graffiti litters the crime scene where two teenagers were gunned down Sunday morning. This may seem out of place in a town and community known for art and hippie culture, but Chief Rick Anglada of Taos Police says the gangs have been a problem here in Taos for more than a decade.
Gangs were starting to creep up then, and everyone, even in law enforcement, thought that it wasn't going to become a problem. And here we are.
According to the district attorney's office, the prevalent gangs here are allied with the Sureños and the Norteños, gangs that started in California. Chief Anglada and Mayor Darren Cordova say the city will be joining the county and state police in a gang task force to try to control the problem.
We're going to do everything we can to put the resources necessary to get to the bottom of it.
District Attorney Donald Gallego says the county has been without a gang task force due to problems finding gang experts. He says he's excited that law enforcement is taking the lead, and his office will also contribute whatever resources are needed.
I want to see some proactive efforts, gang sweeps. I want to see maybe some warrant roundups and maybe some other type of surveillance.
Now, as far as the numbers within the gangs, law enforcement says that's hard to tell because of the transient nature of some of the gang members. They do say that the gangs are multi-generational. You will find a father and son in the same gang. Reporting in Taos County, Joe Griffin, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The DA's office also wants to work with the Juvenile Justice Board to work on keeping young offenders out of gangs.